Are you afraid?
This occurred in 2013 when I lived with my daughter alone. My wife was off to school in another place, and I stayed home to take care of our daughter and hold the house up. My name is Peter, and my daughter was 15 at the time. She had been afraid of the dark ever since she was little, when we let her sleep over at her grandparents' house. Around the time that she was 4, she begged us to stay at their house because her cousin was there at the time, and she wanted to stay and play. We let that happen over the weekend, but the cousin was an evil little bastard, but nobody knew. He convinced her that there were people living in her closet, and that the dark creates monsters. She said that he would flick the lights on and off, freaking her out, telling her that she was going to be taken. He traumatized that poor girl, and she never got over it. It only got worse over the years. When she became a teen, it subsided a little bit, but she still had most of a problem. She needed to sleep with a lamp on, or she'd have panic attacks and come running to me. Otherwise, except for sleeping at bedtime, you couldn't tell in the least bit that she had any problems. She was just a normal, healthy girl. Her and I lived in a cul-de-sac at the time this takes place. I was trying to do paperwork for the job I had at the time in the living room, and it was near dark. My daughter had just gone to her room to go to bed, since she had school in the morning. She came running out of her bedroom to tell me that there was something in her room. I went in there to check, and she kept telling me it was in the closet. Now, I usually know they grow out of this by the time they hit teens, but trauma can last for longer. She swore that she heard sounds coming from in there, so I checked it out. There was nothing there. Her closet was a little bit too messy for something to be hiding in there. So I showed her there was nothing in there, and she looked mostly relieved. She tried to go back to bed. I went back to the paperwork that I'd been procrastinating on until dark. A little while later, she came running back to me to claim that there was something in the closet now. I ran back in there to check again. There was nothing. I told her if she couldn't sleep, to go try my bed out, and I would take hers for the night. So that's what we did. We switched beds. When she didn't come back, I thought that was going to be the end of it. When I finally got tired, I went and got ready for bed myself. I checked on my daughter as well. She seemed to have been able to get to sleep, so I left her with the lamp on as she liked. As I laid down in her room, I thought about my alarm clock that I didn't grab before she fell asleep in there. That wouldn't have been good. I tried my best to sneak back into my bedroom and unplug it without waking her up. I was successful, but once I got back into her room, I started to get a tingle in the bottom of my spine. I only usually get this when I get uneasy. I tried to shake the feeling, but it stayed. As I set the alarm clock up, I heard a clank across the room, and then a thud. It was pitch black in this room, except for the red clock numbers. I reached over and turned the light back on next to the bed, and heard a thump again when I did. I slowly tiptoed over to the closet, and when I got there, I ripped it open. There was nothing there. Still feeling uneasy, I told myself that there was probably a rat somewhere. It shouldn't have been in the walls because they were stuffed with insulation. I walked back over to the bed and tried to sleep. I stayed away for a very long time before I heard another clank and a thump. I quietly got out of bed and snuck back over to the closet where I kept hearing the noise. Maybe if it were a rat, I kept scaring it away. I ripped open the closet doors and hit the light in there. I jumped back and yelled as a scruffy crackhead-looking old guy hopped out of the closet, and started to run out of the bedroom. I noticed before I went after him that the panel to the large vent in the closet was removed. I ran after him through the house, but he was way too fast and got away. He bolted out that door faster than I could get out of that bedroom. I called the police to tell them that there was a guy who broke into my house and was in my daughter's bedroom, but they couldn't do anything but patrol the area. They never found the guy, of course. As for my daughter, she was right to be paranoid. There really was someone in her closet this time. I never thought in a million that something like this could have been covered up by the fear of the same thing. For years, we've been dealing with this, but this time it turned out not to be her imagination. The vent in my daughter's closet was still there, because the previous owners of the house built the closet over a blank wall, and it leads nowhere. It's just stuffed with insulation to block it off. But I found half-eaten food items back there, bags that I assumed were used for drugs, and some other stuff I won't mention. It was a pretty freaky scene, but I cleaned it up and screwed the panel shut before she got up the next morning. She knew nothing, and it was going to stay that way since I wanted my bedroom back. She didn't mention anything the next morning, so thankfully she never figured it out. I didn't want to freak her out because there was some guy in her closet. That weirdo never came back though, and I'm thankful for that. My daughter was able to stay in her own bedroom after that for good. Mentioning that, her fear of dark rooms and someone being in the closet subsided quite a bit over the next few years. I was glad to see that. Her mother also came home, and I debated on telling her about the guy who somehow got inside the house. I went ahead and told her. Yes, it freaked her out, but not as much as I would have thought. We ended up moving across town to a better spot, and it was closer to my daughter's friends anyway. I never got any word on the guy from the closet, though. It's like he never existed to begin with.
If you like this video, consider subscribing. If you are subscribed, hit the bell icon to make sure you never miss an upload. I just have one question for you.
Who is that behind you?